The ongoing COVID-19 pandemic has raised an important question. How well do antibodies protect us from COVID-19 and to what extent? SARS-CoV-2, the virus that causes COVID-19, attaches itself to and infects hosts through a protein present on its surface known as the spike protein. Antibodies are the immune molecules produced by our body that trigger the immune system to kill cells that are infected with the virus. When we get exposed to the virus, our body will recognize it and produce many, many types of antibodies against the virus to protect us from it. And the spike protein of the virus is considered as a good target for these antibodies, since the protein plays an essential role in infecting a person. So how is it possible for the virus to develop resistance to these antibodies or escape these antibodies? SARS-CoV-2 replicates by generating several copies of itself. And as it replicates, certain differences may arise in its genome, which are known as mutations. Now, the virus has different points or regions on it where antibodies can bind and neutralize it or block its ability to infect new cells. If the virus mutates in such a way that the part which an antibody was supposed to recognize and bind to gets changed, the antibody will not be able to help get rid of the virus. Such mutations allow the SARS-CoV-2 to resist or escape antibodies. As more people become infected and the virus replicates and mutates within them, it is possible that different variants of the virus will emerge that will be able to escape the previous antibodies that were developed against it. In fact, a number of genetic variants associated with antibody escape have emerged globally and are in circulation. At least 19 such variants have been identified in the SARS-CoV-2 circulating in India, 18 of which lie in the spike protein of the virus. These variants have been in genomes from at least 9 states till now, including Delhi, Maharashtra, Telangana, West Bengal, Gujarat, and Andhra Pradesh. One such mutation is the N440K in the spike protein of the virus, a mutation in which the 440th position of the spike protein gets changed from an N to a K. This mutation is found in more than 2% of the genomes in India and has a high prevalence in the state of Andhra Pradesh, where over 33% genomes were found to have this mutation. Data suggests that this mutation emerged recently around July or August 2020. Now our bodies produce many, many antibodies against the virus, and a recent study showed that the N440K mutation was completely resistant to one such type of antibody. This mutation was also reported in a case of COVID-19 reinfection from North India. However, more such experiments, data, and analysis will be needed to find the potential clinical impact of this mutation. So the bad news is that SARS-CoV-2 can indeed escape antibodies, but the good news is that now that we know this, we have a heads up. As the pandemic is still ongoing, we now know that it is important to be on the lookout for antibody escape mutations in SARS-CoV-2 and monitor their prevalence across the globe. And the way to do this is through genome sequencing. Genome sequencing not only enabled researchers to identify SARS-CoV-2 very early during the COVID-19 outbreak, it also enabled the rapid development of diagnostic tests such as the RT-PCR diagnostic method, which is still date the most reliable test. It was through genome sequencing that researchers were able to identify key mutations in the virus, such as the N440K mutation that is prevalent in Andhra Pradesh. As new cases continue to emerge, genome sequencing can help monitor the spread of the disease, observe mutations that emerge, and thus be on the lookout for mutations that could escape or be resistant to antibodies. And as vaccines continue to be developed and implemented, genome sequencing can help keep tab on mutations that could allow for vaccine escape.